How to start training your lower body. Everything always starts from the hip hinge when it comes to squats, lunges, step ups, deadlifts, kettlebell swings, or whatnot. You always need to first learn how to hinge your hips and maintain the neutral spine. In fitness, neutral spine means that your back shouldn't be just straight and flat, but you're supposed to arch your lower back a little bit and kind of like push your booty out as much as you can. I'm going to take you to the gym right now and show you how to perform the best exercise to learn the hip hinge movement, which is kettlebell swing. So I'm going to take you to the gym and show you exactly how to get started with your lower body training if you're new to the gym, because I want you guys to be able to train by yourselves and succeed for years. I am not here to promote a 30 days challenge since the new 2020 year has started. I want you guys to be able to maintain the amazing level of fitness all year round. So we need to know where to begin. We need to know how to maintain, how to progress, how to avoid hitting the plateau, and how to constantly improve your body composition. That's why I am here. Any lower body exercises should start from pulling movements, okay? Things like high pulls, snatches, cleans, also kettlebell swings, something like more of a dynamic nature. Then you can go on to squats, all kinds of variations, right? There are box squats, there are different front squats, back squats, deep squats, which do force you to squat below the parallel when your thighs are parallel to the floor. That's called 90 degree squats. When your quads, your thighs are below the 90 degrees, right below that point, then you're squatting under the parallel. So that's actually better for glutes development. But most people start breaking their form if that happens. So when you just begin and you start training in the gym, make sure that you squat until the parallel, meaning that your thighs, right, your quads are parallel to the floor, 90 degrees in your knees, and then you come up. And once you start having the beautiful form with this squat variation, then you can actually go lower, 1 inch below the parallel. So you start your workout with warm-up, then you go to pulling, dynamic moves like snatches and swings and stuff, then you do squats, and then after squats, as a third exercise in your leg workout, you can include some auxiliary moves like lunges, and I have a cheat sheet real quick, step up, so I don't forget what I'm supposed to tell you, step ups, and you finish off your workout with some core work, if that's something that you want to build. And we all should aim to build core strength, because if you have strong core, your squats are better, your deadlifts are better, you can lift heavier weights, your posture improves. So strong core is a must. So you can finish your leg workout with some core work, planks, things like that.